Good afternoon, Grady Knights. Today is Friday, November 22nd. I'm Sophie Eel.
And I'm Rylan Neal. It's holiday season, and Thanksgiving is only a week away.
And we all have that one relative who we know is not the best in the kitchen. So Melanie and Santos have put together some do's and don'ts for the family feast.
Don't reach across the table. It's rude, and you could accidentally spill or drop something. Don't invite too many people. Think about how much space you have and food that can be served.
Where my plate at?
We don't got none.
We don't got that, bro.
Sorry, we didn't know that you were coming, so...
Shoot.
I'm gonna just have to eat the napkin then.
Don't talk with your mouth full. It's very impolite.
Thank you.
Do compliment the chef's cooking, even if it's disgusting.
How is he?
It's not the worst I've had.
Do greet everyone when you enter the room.
Yo, what are you doing, baby?
Do wash your hands before eating. Now you're ready for Thanksgiving dinner.
Some of you may want to impress your friends and family this Thanksgiving, and cooking your own dish is the perfect way. Here's Cooking for Amateurs with Adeline and Dorian.
Hi guys, welcome to Cooking with Amateurs. I'm Dorian.
I'm Adeline.
And this is our Thanksgiving edition.
Cooking for Amateurs.
Today we will be making a Thanksgiving dinner consisting of vegetarian pot pies, sauteed green beans, mashed potatoes, and Oreo truffles. So Dorian, I'm going to start with the pot pies. I thought you could start with the mashed potatoes.
Yeah, I can definitely do that. Sure.
Potatoes. I can definitely do potatoes. Who can't do potatoes?
There's no possible way you can even mash potatoes.
Dorian, how do you not know how to mash potatoes?
No one knows how to mash potatoes!
Are you sure?
How do you make mashed potatoes? I guess you peel the potatoes and then you mash them up and you put in butter and stuff.
With a potato masher? Yeah.
With a masher.
Okay, so I did some quick Googling and it turns out that before you mash the potatoes, you have to cut them and boil them. Who knew? So I guess we just cut these potatoes. Now we have the potatoes. What a rush! Okay, so I boiled and drained the mashed potatoes, so now I finally get to mash them. Add milk and butter. Boom! Mashed potatoes.
To make the pot pie, you need to start with the filling. To make the filling, you need these ingredients. Preheat the oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit and set aside one large oven-proof ramekin.
While that's boiling, we can make the crust. You will need 1 cup flour, 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/3 cup shortening, and 2 to 4 tablespoons of cold water.
On November 9th, Grady held its second coffee house of the school year. Let's take a look with Emily Brown.
My name is Catherine Estrel. I'm a senior. I've been doing theater since freshman year, so fourth year. And last week was the second coffee house that I ever hosted, or co-hosted. This year we had the magic broomstick. So all of our themes are always based off like coffee or stuff you would get in a coffee shop, and we incorporate them with like something seasonal. So it was right after Halloween, so we did like a spooky theme. So on Wednesday, you just scream. So if you have something you want to perform, whether it's like a skit, something original, a poem, a song, whatever, people come and they just have to show it to us and make sure that it's like clean and prepared and good to go for show night. Thursday is really fun. Everybody stays, a lot of people stay right after school, and they set up the entire theater. So it's in the black box, so all the walls are black, but we paint them. So for Magic Broomstick, we had like a bubbling pot with like green bubbles and like a witch on the wall. And it kind of just like makes a fun atmosphere. And so people set up, and then we put all the chairs out for and put the stage up. And then once the doors open, people buy tickets, it's like $5. And everybody takes their seats and the show starts, and it's really, I love Coffee House because it's really casual and it's all student run pretty much. So it's like our own thing. You have a lot of like identity through it as like a theater kid.
Speaking of the stage, have you heard about Grady Drama's next production, Sophie?
Yeah, but I don't know too much about it.
Well, here's GNN's Alea Foote with more information.
On October 6, 1998, a young man named Matthew Shepard was murdered for being gay in Laramie, Wyoming. This was such a big deal because it was a hate crime happening in such a small town, and it affects a whole community. This December, Grady's theater department is showcasing the Laramie Project 10 years later, which will show the tragic effect that Matthew Shepard's death had in a small town.
There was a level of understanding that I had to have before going into doing this play and understanding like the background of homophobia in America and just in general in society and in society now and in the past.
I think that it's beneficial. I think that when people have kind of an in-your-face example of something as strong as something like a hate crime like that, something that was a situation where somebody lost their life simply because of their sexual orientation, I think that it's beneficial to people to see that.
The design of the play brings you closer into what you like, how you feel about the play and the sense of where you are in that moment. So the design makes you feel as if you are where the play is happening, the setting of it.
The Laramie Project will be showcasing December 5th to 7th at 7 p.m. and December 8th at 2 p.m. in the Vincent Murray Theater.
Don't forget, the late work deadline is coming up. All work assigned from September 30th to December 6th will no longer be accepted after December 9th.
Now, let's take a look back at the last couple weeks. Here's Rewind.
On Friday, November 16th, the G3 Robotics team hosted their annual Gaming Gauntlet, where they pit students against one another in an all-competitive fun experience. Along with the games, they provide a long range of snacks available for purchase. The Gaming Gauntlet provided a large variety of games, ranging from 2K to Minecraft to even fun card games. Tickets were $15 at the door. You get two free tournament entries. Any more entries cost $5 additional. The tournament offered cash prizes for the winners in the form of gift cards, but the real tournament prize were the friends you made along the way.
We will be right back.
Not all heroes wear capes. Join B Club every Thursday after school in Mr. Sellers' room, C404, for Honey and Chapstick for the sixth season.
That special time of year again.
It's iPhone season at Sprint.
Switch and get the new iPhone 11 or iPhone 11 Pro with amazing new camera system.
And now you can get the iPhone 11 for $0 a month when you trade in your iPhone 7 or newer in any condition.
Seriously, any condition.
But that's not why we're here. We really want you to subscribe to GNN.
GNN is Grady High School's student-produced news show.
GNN gives you local and school news, sports, and entertainment.
New episodes drop every other Friday starting October 11th.
Search Grady News Now on YouTube, hit the subscribe button to watch a new episode every other Friday. It's that easy.
Even with the winter coming upon us, Grady sports are still in action. Last Thursday, Grady's swim team swam in a dual meet going head-to-head against St. Pius High School. Going up against the reigning boys 5A state champions, Pius won 8 out of 11 events. Despite this, the boys team was led by sophomore Kai McHale, who won 2 events in the 100 backstroke and the 50 freestyle. McHale also swam with Keaton Buchero, Jabari Roden, and Fred Hamilton, who anchored the race, securing a night's win in the 50-meter relay. The girls' results were closer. Grady won more overall events than Pius, but Pius had more swimmers on the podium at the end of the day. Wins by Maggie Watkins, Jory Richardson, and Wyatt Schroeder, along with the 200 free relay, led Grady to a close loss. The Knights will next compete at the Lakeside Invitational, December 13th and 14th. Come out and support our Knights. The Grady boys basketball team started their season off with a huge win against Paideia, winning 64-43. In the second game of the season, the Knights fell to Lakeside 59-49. This season starts a new beginning for Grady basketball with a new head coach, Coach Patrick Johnson, a former Grady graduate. Many players feel Coach Johnson brings a new spirit to the team.
The environment been great, you know. Coach Pat, great coach, bringing the energy to the team, you know, making sure the team come out with a dub this season.
He makes everybody want to play, so yeah, we're going crazy this year.
It's going to bring, you know, the intensity, get a lot of wins this season.
In your first year as head coach, what goals do you have set for the team?
Yeah, I mean, we don't have a specific win-loss record in mind, or you know, we love to compete for the region, make state playoffs, but the most important thing is just getting better every day and really learning how to compete as a group and being our best.
The next home game for Grady basketball is Tuesday, December 3rd against Lithia Springs. This will be the first conference game of the season. The girls' basketball team is currently 0-2. They lost to Paideia and Lakeside, but hope to turn it around this Saturday at the Chattahoochee High School and the Roswell Rotary Honor Air Invitational. Both the boys and girls will be competing in this tournament. It starts at 3 p.m. Good luck to our Knights. Hope to see you this winter at sporting events. See you next week on GNN Sports Splash. Happy Thanksgiving.
It's time now for a GNN classic, Knight Fight. Hosts Lily Nevins and Jorge Navarrete pit knights against each other to see who will be the victor.
Hello and welcome back to Knight Fight, the show where we pit knights against each other in battles of wit and skill.
Today we have a special edition of Knight Fights, a Thanksgiving edition. Let's meet our contestants.
Kevo.
I'm Daniel.
Hi, I'm Da Bob.
First up, we have a turkey race.
You've heard of a chicken fight, well this is a turkey race,
where each contestant will get on their partner's back and race each other.
3, 2, 1, go!
It's a pretty even start. Let's see who wins.
Oh, it's a photo finish. Let's see who gets the win. Wow, team one really pulled that out by a hair.
How does it feel to win?
Feels amazing.
All right, so how do you feel going into this second competition?
I'm pretty confident because Stanley's pretty good at making funny faces and Kevin is really bad at not laughing, so it should go well.
Whoever holds the apple juice inside of their mouth without laughing for the longest period of time wins this round.
All right, 3, 2, 1, go.
Wow, let's see that again.
How did you keep from laughing?
Well, I knew that Kevin was a pretty easy opponent, so I just had to not laugh before he did. And, you know, it was pretty easy right when I made a stupid face. He immediately started laughing and then spit out his apple juice.
All right, do you think you can pull out the win in the turkey eating contest?
Sure. Me and Daniel are units.
Next up, we have a turkey eating contest. Whoever finishes first wins.
3, 2, 1, go.
Owen and Stanley seemed to be in the lead.
So what was your strategy going into it?
I just shoved as much turkey as I could into my mouth. You know, at first there was a problem trying to chew, but then I started shoving it down my throat. It worked out.
All right. Hit that one.
We pulled out the dub.
Thank you for tuning into this week's episode of Night Fight.
Make sure to tune in next week.
Holiday Dress Up Week will be December 9th through the 13th.
Monday, wear pajamas. Tuesday, wear your ugliest sweater. Wednesday, wear holiday-themed hats and socks. Thursday, wear holiday colors, and Friday is Candy Cane Day.
There are so many things to be grateful for, and this is the time of year that we recognize all of them. Janin went around to find out what Grady students and staff are thankful for this year.
I am very thankful for the opportunity that this country has given me to continue doing what I really like to do, which is to teach and continue teaching you and, you know, creating a good connection with my students. Hopefully you will not forget about me in the future.
I am thankful for everyone in this community, in the community of Grady.
I'm thankful for my sons, David and Oliver, and I'm also thankful for all the other students here at Grady High School. It's so fun seeing all y'all's faces every day.
I'm thankful for the break, and I'm thankful for my friends and family.
Cool. What are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for being able to spend time with my family and music.
I am really thankful that I have a job that I like and a job that feels like I'm at home when I'm here. And I'm thankful that I have really good students that I really, really like. And of course, my pets.
I'm thankful for my friends and family.
I'm thankful for friends, family, and the faculty, staff, and students here at Grady High School.
I'm thankful for my new friends at Grady because they've helped me have a smooth transition into a new school.
Thanks for watching GNN. Tune in December 13th for the next show.
And don't forget to subscribe to GNN.
Have a great break.
All right, great job. That's a wrap. Time to get on out of here. I got a party to go to. Let's get on out of here. All right.
Hey,
you good?
Come on.
Have a great break, Mr. Albert.
Right, you too. I'll see you. Good job, guys.
Do you have any plans for break?
Yeah, you know, just some baby stuff, probably.
Down.